For who don't know, my name is Franklin Petty, and what happened, I receive a letter the 27th of July on a Saturday. Two police officers bring a letter from Keekley Lake and Associates. And this letter was dated the 23rd of July. What happened, I asked the officers for their names and they was refusing to tell me. So I asked them, how come? I say, I leave from the road, come up my yard, and don't want to tell me and want to give me a letter. Okay, and what happened? They lied that I was Webster Darryl Mitchell. I wrote the bank manager, Val Banks here, letter, tell him not to proceed with any foreclosure because the matter pending before a tribunal. This is our next letter again went to the same manager of the bank. But what happened, if you notice, this letter here from Keekley Lake and Associates, if you look here at the partners, they got Keekley Lake, Yvette Wallace, Ken Porter, Colin Buck. Yvette Wallace is head over the Bar Association. National Bank is one of the biggest shareholders in Anlet. So in terms of me with all these liars and things, I could see the reason why I can't get a fair and honest settlement. So here, from the liar I had from a week, I want you to look at this date here, Monday, September 24, 2012, at 11:24 a.m., went to Ivinia Benjamin to tell me that he tell her not to put a date unless all the composition of the acts being in place for the Fair Labor Standards Act. In a dispute under the Fair Labor Standards Act Section 15, go over to Section of the Labor Department, which point out the same report we asking for. We are supposed to have a liar and an assessor, which I point out in the other videos stating that she hold the meeting March 7th without me having a liar. She summons the wrong person to be my assessor. And in the same tribunal, she asking me if my assessor was Dennis Fleming, which she had known. But still, I, in the essence, she want to conduct it the way they want. Under the criminal code, state public officers receiving property to show favor. The same Angel Wilson, which I point out in the earlier videos, where she had this whole thing pending because I don't want to send over these reports, which we were asking for all the time. That a matter pending, causing all this hardship to me and my family. I went by the course. When I went there, I asked for Court of Appeal forms, then give me these. I get a Court of Appeal form, which I explained in the video that I had followed this. Carrot and them tell me must come back the Monday when I called the Friday, and when I went back, I was locked up. A continual going back by the courthouse. I asked them for two high court farms, waiver farms, and also what I was lacking for from the 9th of November 2012. Them tell me that me ain't got no farms. I went to the registrar and other people let them say that me ain't got these things. If you notice here, this is the Anguilla Public Service Code of Ethics, which outlines certain things what I'm supposed to be doing. In this, telling you where here. See here, these now all public servants is under the general order, where I went by the courthouse to get these papers. Them got this big and broad inside of the same book to serve with integrity. If you notice here, this same person, I went there so she keep telling me I come back here all the time, I hear 100 times. And asking for the same thing, them everybody tell me that they ain't got none. So she cussed me off in front of customers, tell me not to come back here again with this stupidness. I went by one of the government, explained the situation. He said that to his knowledge, he know that there's no other place but to go get these farms, but they were the courthouse. Under the general order, when the public servants in performing in their duties, in the golden four, section 4 tells you when they may performing them duties, a number of things supposed to be done. But as you can see, everything that happening to me is because of friendship. So nobody ain't enforcing no laws to tell who underneath them what to do in terms of carrying out these laws. What happened? I had an incident there with my young child. She was outside playing on the porch and happened to fall in the banister. Bust her head. She bust her fired open. I had no gas in the car. I had no money. And a friend come to take the child to hospital. So I tell my wife and she go down there, so tell them that it's the government what got all of this, what happening to us. Because the same government here is what holding up this matter from the going forward. The child, it was so serious that the child had to end up taking stitches. I could not pay for it, somebody else substitute and pay for it. A few days later, I see my son riding around on his bike with a piece of napkin wrapped around his finger. So I call him and I ask him what happened to his finger. Tell him to take it off for me to see. When he take it off, his finger turned on the side how it was swelled, so big, and with something on the side, so when I squeeze it now, the bust out the whole side and was showing the bone there with his finger. So I turned now and take him to the hospital, the clinic. When I got up to the clinic, I explained to the doctor that I don't have no money, but my child need medical attention. I explained her the situation, what happened. She called one of the heads down at the hospital and explained her. She tell her that she can't leave the child like that because it's serious and the child needs attention and she can't leave it unattended. So I was sent down by the hospital now to see if I would get this medication for the child. When I gone down there, so I went to the person that was I was sent to. She called her wrong and tell her. And the people she called tell her that is a welfare situation. I tell her, no, this is a government situation. It is a labor dispute. They didn't want to settle fairly. And all the time I trying to get these things, them people run me around. So she referred me to the cashier. This was after 9. I went out in the waiting room, sit down till after 11:30. The cashier come out to me. She tell me that she sorry she can't do nothing about it. She can't give me permission to get a medication. So she asking me if I can get a family member to pay for it. I tell you, everybody got their own responsibilities and this is mine. I turn out from there after being refused by the hospital. I turn out from there, went over by the Ministry of Home Affairs. I spoke with one of the same people who sit down inside of the meeting when the manager chose the payout from, and them stand up now to cripple me and my family because them don't want it settled the way it's supposed to be, and contacting all them friends to throw me out from me getting it in court. He don't tell me that is a welfare matter and medical and health department supposed to deal with it. I tell him, listen, this is a matter pending from in here in the same department. And them coming there so conduct it the way them want. Not pertaining to the laws which is supposed to be conducted under. Okay, he said ain't nothing he could do about it. That's an hour went home. The child in pain still. I went sit down in the office the morning. I asked to speak with Jerome Roberts, who over the department. An elected member from District 2. I wait there so, them calling, see him coming down, opening the door. I approach him, he asked me to explain. The girl, one of the secretaries, tell him that must carry me in the conference room. I tell her this ain't nothing to go sit in no conference room. I just here to explain a matter in the gang. I ain't come for no long talk. Because I tell him I went out by the house, explain the situation with the child first. I explain the situation with his son, my son that I carried here. I show him, I tell him, I get this from the doctor. To go by the hospital to get a medication free. I explain to him, I tell him the same department which Elias writing to get these reports, them refusing to send. I explain to him, I tell him that he tell me that Angel Wilson said, get a lawyer, write to her, and she will send these reports. I tell him I went over there, them tell me I got get him and Ivania Benjamin was appointed. I never get reports. I get several liars to write them, no reports. So I say, I can't get it and the liars can't get it. So he tell me that, he asked me if the done, he said that, I tell him it, the tribunal was the 7th of March. She summons the wrong person and she come there do it the way she wants. So he says she say she want to do it over again. She got stay on it. I tell him what kind of stupid games I'm playing because our laws didn't say when you bring someone from away you come here and you broke our laws to say every person in Angola who committed an offense. in Section 4 state anything with a jurisdiction partly be within or beyond should be tried and punished in the same manner. But because them don't want to face the punishment while them there causing, them run around beating on the bush, crippling me and my family, and tell him, so I tell him, tell me must go back to the hospital. Find out how much the medication costs and come back out here so I may have to refund it. I say, refund that. I say, it is a matter, are you causing? And how I could be refunding are you? Okay, when by the hospital get the amount, which I tell her to write here so on the same prescription, how much the cost, and I got a carry back by the government minister. When I got back out here, so he had a correct amount, nothing over nor under. So which means them had some kind of communication in between. I went back, he got tell me, he gave me the money, I tell him, look, go and write up something, let me carry back out here, so. I ain't accepting no money like that. So he said, for the child, you know, for the child's sake. I say, but Jerome, this is nothing just about a child. This is a family where I'm here causing. So, due that the child was in pain, I take the money and I tell him, listen, them as government ministers should enforce the laws that they're writing for the rest to follow. And if he can continue taking money out of his pocket, because he don't want to offend his subordinates who in there, so who underneath him, he can have a big problem. And this is a problem we got. We got here, so as long as you're a friend to them, you broke the laws, all kind of crimes for nothing, and get away with it. National Bank. Tell him I want to speak with the manager, Val Banks, then put me on to his secretary. I asked who it is I speak to, she said her name is Shanika Kano. So she keep running me around the bush, don't want me to speak with the manager. So she keep asking me if she could get permission to go in my account to pull up the information. I tell her she's just a secretary. I want to speak with the manager himself. I later went back by the bank now. This was the 23rd. This 22nd would be last week, Thursday. Speaking to one of the loan officers, I find out that banks had never had a secretary. So I say, well, somebody misleading me. I asked to speak with someone who's in charge over the bank. He asked me if I might want to speak to Bernardine Hospital. I tell him, no, I want to speak with the manager who over the bank itself. So he told me that I have to go to a chain of command. So he called Janice Proctor. Janice Proctor asked me what the reason. I tell her, well, I want to speak with the bank manager concerning a matter I have at the bank. Now if you look at it, the business of the bank is the customers. But as the owner's customer, can I see the bank manager? I went there so for a printout of my history, loan history. I was given a paper to sign, our contract to sign, to hold me responsible for them 10% here with the liar fees, which a letter from the Lake Associates I had here, so will come to me. This is one of them. This is the first one I get. If you notice here, I get this, the 18th, from this liar there. The next one that come to me The next letter that come to me, which I shown earlier, I'll show again. My next slide here. This liar, Keithley Lake and Associate, is the National Bank liars. So I tell them I don't have to sign no contract to get no history. I never sign none. But these are all the tricks they're pulling. I spoke with Janice now the 22nd. She tell me what happened. She got find out what's going on. And call me back the Friday, which would be the 23rd, and leave me know if I could speak with him. 23rd come Friday, I wait a while, I call the bank, I ask to speak to her, this around 10:30. She tell me that she was just going in a meeting, and she got call me back as soon to over, leave me know what happened. Time went by, I call back, around 1:30 I get her, she tell me I can't see her. I then hang up, I call back the bank. The person that answered the phone, I asked him to speak, if I could speak with someone at head of the bank. They asked me why I want to speak to him about, I tell him concerning bank business, I a customer there. So she asked me like what, because she said the bank had a number of different things, like to who to put me to. So she said they got billing, loan, section, whatever, she keep going on. So I said we're concerning a bill. So she said a bill? I said yeah, a loan. She said a loan, okay, she tell me hold on a few minutes. She put me on to some person, she tell me her name is Goza. And she is the secretary for the people who just come over the bank. So she keep asking me what is it when I talk to him about, I explain her. So she tell me, I tell her that I don't want to speak to her on no phone. I want to talk to her in person. So before I hang up, I ask her her name, she tell me her full name, she tell me Angela Goza. Okay, she tell me where she have to go away for the weekend or so. And she might come back Monday or so. So I say, after I hang up the phone, I turn around and I went back down by the bank. I went to the bank there, so I asked them, I tell her I don't know if I had the right section of the bank, but I called and to get some assistance, and some Angela goes to tell me that she secretary over these people over the bank that come here now. So she called, she went behind, she started talking with another lady, them laughing. She called on the phone, she tell the person that I here to speak to her. So she asked me if I want to speak to her on the phone. I tell her no, I want in her office. So she turned and tell her back the same thing what I say, and then start laughing. So she tell me have a seat. I see two ladies approaching me. Well, over there sitting down and point after me, I move. Over there, texting on the phone. So I look up again, she called my name, she say Franklin, I say yes, she say come. So I got, she introduced herself, she said the lady who there with her, a young girl is her assistant. So the expression on her face, I'm busting with a laughing off or something. But I see to a dumb setup. So I asked her if I could meet with the head, no, the person who in charge, she told me know that he sent the two of them to find out what is I want to meet with them for. And I tell her that I just explained her. So I want to talk to the head. Because we talked before over the phone about the same thing. So she said, well, I can't meet her right now. So I say, when could I meet her? She said she don't know, she would have to find out and call me back. No, she just said she just leave from Bahamian and he wanted to know why I'm talking about. She big grin on her face, you know, and she busts out laughing. So the young one tell her, try to get my number, you know, so she could contact me. She says she got it already. So I see the what I was up to, so I tell her I'm okay, I turn off. The staircase when you enter the doors in National Bank, we were just below there, inside of the open hall. Before I even reach to go out the door, and them just turn them back, them bust out a laughing. See, he really fought with her and start going out, you know? So him bust out a laughing so hard. I walk outside the bank, went down the step, I could hear him laughing still. So I come back up, I went back and I asked if these people are come from a way that take over the bank now. If any lady come with them, if them tell me no, that means no lady went in with these people. But I don't know if down by CCB, I have any lady there so that come with them. And I turn off. As I see all the tricks them playing, wherever I I called by the governor's office a day. That was when the other governor was here, so not this lady. I said to them I want to speak with the governor. The lady asked me my name. I said Franklin Petty. So I asked her to speak with a lady there, so that was there. Them tell me that I could go and talk to this lady, so I could get make an appointment to meet with the governor. So she tell me that she ain't there, and she could call me back just to come in. So she hang up the phone. I say, what is strange? Because how she could call me back in my phone on private? I take up the phone again, just hang up the phone. Take up the phone, dial the same number. I get the same person who just talked to me. So I tell her, I want to speak with the lady who I was referred to and who she just told me wasn't there. So she asked me my name. I find when I give my name, I get you with nothing because I'm beating me on the bush and blocking me out. So I give her a different name. Directed to the same person should just tell me wasn't there. So you see the tricks who are ever playing? All kind of thing them doing because them don't want to come to no fair settlement. I went to the court, I can't get no farms, which the court supposed to have these things. Nowhere else you could get these things but the court. So all this run around and getting because they want to stick up with a manager who them saying were managing over handling. And my family suffering from all of that. So you see, with the kind of connection that involved with everybody, because of friendship and not following carrying out the laws. Said that when I tell Shania Petty that she was a liar and she should know these things to prove it. Shania Petty used to also work at Keekley Lake and Associates. So them getting all them friends to tie in with this thing and to crucify me and my family. Further to this, there's two other videos. You could also go on YouTube. In YouTube search bar, you type in my name, Franklin Petty. FranklynPetty. And you'll see two videos that will outline other details in it.